Hey guys, what's up? It is me, Kingdom Hunter, from the video, and we're back to the next part of Let's Play Minecraft on the our Minecraft server here, Wolfcraft. My little intro thingy talk bit here always changes for some reason. But yeah, we're back, and in this video, what we're gonna be working on is as you can see behind me, we're gonna be working on the little back area here. I'm gonna on camera, I'll show off what I've done. Basically, we're gonna get the redstone and the actual look of the actual like stall or stand. What I'm gonna call it I don't know what to call it because it's I can't think of the word on top of my mind. But this top part is what this area back here is what we're gonna work on. I'm not gonna get the roof done. I'm gonna get the roof done off camera because I don't know how I want to design it yet because I have a few ideas. One, I have a couple of different ideas to do it. I just have to figure it out. But yeah, so yeah, that's what we're gonna be doing. One of the three things we're doing in this video is showing off me working on this thing. So I got some materials together. I also want to let you guys know in this video I'll show off the fix I did to the blaze farm on then the fix I did to the iron farm. Apparently, I found out that the iron farm in 1.16.2 got broken. It's not 16.1, but 16.2, it broke, and so there's just a small change, I'll show off after I finish this part. So, I'm going to cut it here, I'll be right back guys when I have more to show off of the current build working on this, the back area here, my casino. See you guys in a sec. Alright guys, I am back, and I finished the look of this back area, as you can see here in front of me. Completely done. Still haven't done the redstone for it, but I at least have a look of it done. Took me a little while longer than I thought, but I got it done. It looks, I like it. Have barrels for it. I have barrels for where you would place your the money. And the way it was gonna work, it's gonna be based off of a little bit lag. You place your whatever your money is in here, and then I think what I'm gonna do is have a dropper underneath this block here that's gonna send up the item basically in front of each of these. This is the front look of it. I had to change some bits of this before. It was 3 blocks long, and then I make it 4 so that this little countertop spot kind of fit in the area. So. Yeah, this is what it looks like from the front, and then I made these little neat little doorways. When you go inside, I have a nice little roof, different patterns. I added in some detail, like in real life, if you see a pillar like this sticking out, it would have a support thing, I think, like that. So that's what that's for. And because there's no actual beam in the wall here, I just took it out, stuck 2 beams out here. Cause to me, it made sense. That I have some hidden lighting behind each of these things so you won't see any torches, but it's lit up enough to where nothing can spawn back here. I have this open so I can put the redstone in the redstone stuff in. And if I look from the top view, now I don't know if we put doorways on this or not, but for now I'm gonna leave it open. But yeah, the top view here is this. I made the roof go down one, so I don't have to put any torches here. Well, actually, I still do. I put the roof down one just because, I don't know, I figured less spawning areas for mob stuff. This is what it looks like from the top. But yeah, that's done. That's all that's done for the look of it. The next thing is redstone, which I don't know. I'm debating on doing in this video or not, and it's gonna be pretty basic. I'm gonna pause here. And think about it. If I want to do the redstone, I'll do it. I'll unpause it. And I'll come back to you guys when I've decided if I want to show you the next thing. The next thing I fixed that's broken, or if I want to show off the redstone. Be right back, you guys, in a second. Alright guys, I am back, and I said not to do, well, I kind of did some of the redstone. I did one of them. I'm going to show you what it looks like. It's basically going to be this, just copied X amount of times. The basic, whatever this is called, filter where, you know, you have X amount of items, and then you have whatever the money is. Well, you would have like that, and then, you know, whatever the amount of money is. Oh, there you go. So only those items can go through, and yeah, that's basically it. One thing, again, I don't know if I've said this in a previous video or not, though, but one thing I hope they add in this game is the gold hopper, where it's like the normal hopper, but it does this. It does the item filter, but all in it, in the gold hopper. All they want to do is to shift this over to here, a few of these blocks, I'm going to call it, like, one or two blocks over here. And another YouTuber did a little video about it, a mod video about it, where all you have to, and then you have these four for the inventory, and then an extra box like here where my mouse is. I think only one of those, like, where around where my mouse cursor is, and that's where you would put like whatever the item you want to filter out, and then that's it. You know, so you would have one being for the filter item, and then four others for the inventory, and there's no redstone needed. It's just the hopper itself. Which honestly, I'm gonna say this. They took this. I've said this in the previous video. This, the elytra, and a few other things from mods. The elytra is technically speaking the glider from Open Blocks. This is from another weird mod. I wouldn't be surprised if eventually they have conveyor belts and a few other stuff that are probably from mods. And I mean, most of their stuff is their own, and the elytra is their own. It's their version of a mod. But the gold hopper should be a thing, and I hope it's a thing in the future. But yeah, I'm going to show off what I had to do to fix the iron front here. Yeah. So it's working amazingly now. But to show it off, I think I just make sure. Let's just take a look up here. The way to fix it, it works the same way as the old version. The zombie here will scare the villagers, and then the iron golem spawn. Now the way to fix it, this version of it, is apparently now you have to move these three blocks here, half slabs, and that got changed. Apparently they can't see past the half slabs, so all you have to do is change that and make it where the where it's carpet now with string above it. Well, not because they don't see them, but because the villagers can't actually sleep, can't go to sleep, because the blocks were in the way, because the new bed changed with blocks around the bed. It doesn't just affect the player, it also affects the villagers too, so that's why you need the carpets above it. Which... I forgot. Tad, the carpet there, but it looks like it's fine. Also, apparently you don't need the workstations anymore. That's I think what they're titled as. For the villagers to count this as a iron golem spawning here, but I just left them in just in case. And also, I recommend putting string above those so nothing spawns above them, like iron golems. But yeah, that's all I did on both sides, and if your iron golem farm stopped working, and use my design to build your iron golem farm, all you have to do is do this change with the carpet and stuff and string, and you're basically good to go. You know, I did have to fiddle with the water a bit, because for some reason the water would go to the edge here, and the iron golem would still see the villager, I think, or the zombie, sorry, and they wouldn't go fully down. They would just sit here and they wouldn't go down the water. They would basically be attracted to the they wouldn't want to go down, basically. They wouldn't want to fall. And I could maybe fix that by lowering this water by a few blocks, but I'm not going to do that. So if this is a fix I did. So if this part basically, if the iron golems are clogging up here, that's how you have to fix it. It's a little slower because they slowly fall into the instant fall, but it works. But that is the change to the iron golem farm to get it to fully work. As you can see. Because I was always wondering why I wasn't getting iron, and then I found a, I looked up a 1.16.2 iron farm, and I found out the guy stated that the bed change to players also affect the villagers. So yeah, I think this does work better off during the night versus during the day because they sleep during the night. I think that's so I think that's what it is as well. I'm rambling. Alright, let's go on to the next change for the blaze farm. I figured out a way to fix the blaze farm to make it actually work. I need to be in survival. Now, so I so far have fixed the... because it's just easier to go around. So yes, I fixed the iron farm, did the build on the casino, and then fixed the blaze farm here. I still have to fix a few other things. This video isn't going to be too long. I don't know if you guys like longer videos or shorter videos. I also went around and placed blocks down because this, for some reason, was missing parts, as you can see, like parts of this got corrupted. I don't know what happened. Maybe we dug it out, we're digging it out, or Sam went and dug it out. But I had to fix it so we can get to here. And this doesn't work. As you can see, it gets blaze rods. The way it works is an actual old version that Etho did, YouTuber Etho, is the way it works is the blaze spawns, falls down here, hits this, which is full of minecarts. Full of minecarts, this little thing activates, and the way this thing works is if multiple blazes fall here, it doesn't activate until this is a lock thing where it locks it and delays it basically, so it can have multiple blazes here and it'll still constantly activate and send the minecart out. And then that's what I did on both sides. And then they just go up, over here, hit this little thing here, that it, what it does is it goes here, hits the cactus, the minecart breaks, because the activator letters are shit, honestly, crap in this game, because it'll work the way we want them to, so that's why you need that. But after the blaze, the minecart breaks and blaze lands here, the repeaters activate, pushes the blaze this way onto this hopper, and pushes it this way, but then the guy falls here, and that is on both sides the same thing where they land there and they get pushed on both sides. The problem with the activator rails is you wouldn't need the this would work still for the activator rail if the activator rail flung the mob off, and then the activator rail, after the mob came off of the activator rail, the minecart went back down. But that's the issue; it doesn't go back. That's the thing. So that's why you use the cactus. Because the way it should work is the mob gets off it, doesn't spawn on the block, but spawns next to the track. I don't know. The way they have it should be changed just a little bit, basically. But yeah, that's basically how that works. And the way the minecart goes back, it goes into these hoppers. And this activates this little clock thing here. Little delayed clock thing here. That allows the items to... I had two of them. Well, actually, I don't think I actually need this one. Basically, this gets powered, and then the drops all activate, which is faster than hoppers. Which gets this going, which automatically gets... Basically, it's a long line basically a pipe. That's what I call it. A pipe that sends the items this way, then down down to the dish dropper, which then activates this little thingy, I forgot what they're called, which activates this little line here to get the to have the droppers face downwards vertically, which gets them to this little barrel, which I have full of minecarts, so that way we have a back stock in case any of the minecarts get stuck in any of the droppers. As you can see, it won't get stuck there, but it will get stuck there, but then it goes down here and replaces the one that gets taken out. It's I did that, yeah. So that's all that works, and that's I'm talking a lot, sorry. And that's how that all works. It like I said, I call it a pipe. My original version was to just do it off of the starting one, but a lot of them get stuck like here-ish, and then I've added that one, then they all get stuck like here-ish in one of these droppers, and so, and also because for some reason the way these work, they don't actually work vertically downwards. So if this activates, it won't. And say if there's two observers facing downwards, and this one activates, it won't actually activate. It's a weird thing that it doesn't activate in a chain downwards. It's the best way I can explain it. But yeah. Then I have the same thing over here. Goes up there. This I had to finesse a little bit to get it to fit, but I was able to fit it nicely. So yeah, it goes around here, goes around here, goes down here, goes down here, and I have the same thing here. Little this thingy. Top. Another barrel that has full. No. There you go. This one for some reason has them backstocked here, but that's fine. And then same thing over here, I have the same thing where it goes down the hopper chain, the dropper chain there. And what I did for this one is actually I had it for, I didn't do the vertical droppers, all I did is had droppers go in a line like that, go here, and then get dropped straight down. I built this second, I built that one first, that one over there first, and then this one, and after building this one, I realized I could have done this over there as well, but instead of taking out the redstone and changing it, I'm just going to leave it the way it was, the way it is. But yeah, that is the iron farm and the blaze farm both fixed. I can demo it here. You basically stand here on this block, because this is where they both spawn. And you can hear them go off. They all get pushed down into the middle. There's one issue with this one. You hear it go off. Is that the clicking? You'll have to, because it, yeah, it's not silent, quiet when it does that. Is that too bad? But yeah, that's the only issue with this. You do have to sit here for about 5-10 minutes to get a bunch of them, but that is. Oh, let's just die. Sorry about that, I just died here. But that is it for this video, basically. Nice and simple. Also, yeah, I had to add this flap here because when these guys were sitting on this on the hopper, they were actually able to hit me, so I mean, they still can, I guess, but not as much as they were before, so. But yeah. That is it for this video. That is the iron bone farm and the blaze farm fixed. If basically, The only way to do dual blaze farm is the way I did it, which is from another YouTuber, big YouTuber called EthosLab. He did an old, like 1.12-ish version, where that's how the design I have, well, with the minecarts, is his design. The way the minecarts get retrieved is the same. I think the way he did it is he did a minecart chest with the minecart in it. He basically did two rails for each thing, so when the minecarts go up there, they get put into a minecart chest and then go back down and get, and that's how he did it. That's the only difference I have for mine versus his. But yeah, hope you guys didn't enjoy the video. Hopefully the video also helped you guys out, fix your iron farm and your blaze farm if you use my video to build your stuff or fix your stuff or whatever it is. Hope you guys did enjoy the video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I am out. Sorry that this video was mainly 5-ish minutes of me just talking, but that's kind of how I wanted to do this video. I wanted to show off what I fixed and stuff. But yeah, see you guys in the next one. Peace out.